And welcome back. It's Nick here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create an auto-marked exam, which is a personal favourite of mine. This is one of the areas where Exam.net really shows its strengths, and it is one of the biggest time-saving aspects of the platform. With auto-marked exams, you enter each question into Exam.net. We offer a variety of answer formats, and you set up the marking rules for each question. That way, Exam.net does most or all of the marking automatically. You can create both simple quizzes or more sophisticated exams. So let's have a closer look. You start by clicking New Exam in the top menu. Give your exam a name. I'm here going to create a test on US cities. Now choose the auto-marked exam type. Okay, so let's take a moment to look at this screen. At the top, you see Edit and Preview. We start in Edit mode, which is where we will create all our questions. When we're done, we can preview the question and check that the marking works as we expect. In the middle of the screen are all the different types of questions you can create. Let's briefly go through each type before we create an actual exam. The information block is primarily a way to add text or images to an exam, for example, a set of instructions at the start, without having an actual question connected to it. Using the multiple choice question type, you can let the student select one or several correct alternatives. Simple answer questions give the students one box to write the answer in, and the answer is either correct or incorrect. Fill the gaps questions allow the students to replace missing words or numbers from a text. When using the match answer question type, the student is asked to match options that pair up. This is done by clicking the two alternatives that belong together, which will draw a line between them. Free text questions are not possible to automark. However, they can be used in the same exam as auto-marked questions, making them a useful complement. Using the answer with attachment question type, the students can attach a Desmos construction or handwritten work, for example. So, let's create an exam so I can show you that it really is easy to set up and is also very powerful. I'll be constructing a test on US cities, and I'll demonstrate each of the four auto-marked question types, starting with multiple choice. Regardless of what question type you select, first you compose the actual question, which can include a picture or a formula, and then you define the answers. Now, multiple choice works pretty much as you would expect. First, I enter the question. And then I set the possible answers. Then I select the correct answer or answers here. For this question, there is only one right answer. So now you have to decide how you want this question presented to your students. If you want your students to only be able to select one answer, choose the radio option. Whereas if you want to allow them to choose multiple answers, then select the checkbox option. Above the answers, there is a small button which you can use to randomise the order in which the answer choices are presented. I usually leave this on as an added cheat prevention in the classroom, since it hinders a student from seeing which option their neighbour selects. On the other hand, I might have a question where the answer option needs to be in a specific order. In that case, I click the button with the straight lines. Now, let's talk about marking. Marking options are shown here below the questions. For this question, there is only one right answer, so I'll select the 1 point per correct answer option. Now we're done with this question. But before we leave it, let's make a small change to this question so I can show you another aspect of marking. Let's see what happens if we change the question to which of these cities are in California instead. Now there are two right answers, so let's unselect Miami and select San Francisco and Los Angeles. The options for radio and checkbox are now hidden since this question requires students being able to select more than one answer. Okay, so now let's look at the marking. If we stick with 1 point per correct answer, this question becomes worth 2 points, because now there are two correct answers. If you want this question to be worth only 1 point, then unselect that option. So now, if a student only gets one right, they will not get partial credit. When you're done, click OK to save this question. It's now been added as the last question on the exam. Now I'll add another question, and this time I'll select the simple answer type. First I enter the question, and then I type the correct answer. At this point, I'll just have a look under the settings icon in the upper right-hand corner. Here I can define how sensitive the auto-marking should be, and if I want to be strict, I can activate case sensitive, meaning that the student will have to answer New York exactly as it's written, with the correct capital letters, for example. On the other hand, I have the option of adding additional accepted answers, and therefore making room for alternative interpretations, if you like, of the correct answer. The marking is straightforward. A correct answer gives 1 point, and so I save the question, and it's now placed below the previous one. As you can see, various buttons have now appeared, making it possible to change the question order in my test. Okay, so now I'm going to add another question, and this time I will create a fill the gaps question. Type in the question as usual. Now I go to the word I want to create a gap for, in this case Houston, and I click the button Add Gap. The word is now replaced by a gap in the question, and the correct answer is automatically created below. I'll also make gaps for the words Florida and Minnesota. I can also change the gap sizes under settings so that I won't give away too much to the students by the size of the gap. The marking rules here have a lot of flexibility. For example, I can demand that all gaps be correct in order to give 1 point, or maybe 2 out of 3. Or I can use the 1 point per gap shortcut, as I'll do here. So now I've written 3 questions, and I'm now going to add a match answers question. As usual, I write the question. And now I add each correct pair. The options will be presented in the order they are listed. Exam.net will then mix up the matching options when presenting the question to the student. A really good feature here is that you can add extra incorrect matching options as a distraction if you want to really make sure that the students know their stuff. If you want to reorder or edit, you can then click on a specific option and use the tools that then appear. From here, you can reorder and you can edit and delete items, for example. Again, I'll select the 1 point per correct answer option and add this question to my test. As you can see, you also have the option to add additional questions or to add sub-questions. Sub-questions, parts A and B, for example, are more important at times when you might want certain questions to be grouped together. If you choose later to randomise the question order, then exam.net will only randomise the main questions and not the sub-questions attached to them. During the making of an exam, you can always preview the exam by clicking on the Preview tab on the top left, and you can also check the marking rules by activating the marking switch on the top right. Once you're happy with the exam, you click on OK, and then you're presented with the options to randomise the order of the questions and hide points for students during the exam. The auto-mark tests are conducted in the same way as any other type of exam. So in the same way, you can add built-in tools to your students' menu, and you have the same security options to choose from. This type of exam is started in exactly the same way as for all other exams on exam.net. You simply give the exam key to the students and they use it to access the exam. The added benefit of this type of exam, of course, is that you don't have to do too much marking afterwards. You can see directly a summary of your students' results or go in and look in detail at an individual student's answers. More about this in a future video.